Hi, everybody. This is Harry, UX researcher at Useberry. Today, I'm going to share with you Useberry's open and closed cart sorting updates. These updates give you more control over your cart sorting status by introducing new setup options and enable you to analyze your results in depth by providing more views. Let's start with the closed cart sorting. The first thing that you'll notice is that carts and categories have been separated. You can now add carts in bulk and you can also add categories in bulk. Let's move back to the cart view and explore the new options that Useberry offers. Add tooltip description. Once enabled, you will see that in each cart a description field appears. You can enter your description and the participants will be able to view the description you have added for this cart once they place their mouse over the eye icon that appears within this cart. Let's move on to the Add Images on Cart. With this option, you can add images on your cards. Just click the Upload Image and upload a new image to your workspace or use an image that you have already uploaded in your workspace. With Useberry, you can now hide the card title labels, giving you the opportunity to only present the images to the participants. This option is only available once the Add Image on Cart is also enabled. You can also randomize the cart order. What this means is that participants will see the cards in a randomized order, and this will reduce the bias of your study. The last option within the cards view is the Require Participants to Rank Cards. Once enabled, when the participant drags and drops a card into a category, they will see a number right next to the card. This number represents the position of the cards within this particular category. Let's continue with the categories view. You can now add a tooltip description in the categories view. The participants will be able to view this description that you have added once they place their mouse over the eye icon that appears in this category. With Useberry, you can now add categories cart limit. Once the option is enabled, you can add a cart limit for a category. So, for example, if I add a cart limit of 2, Category 1 will only accept 2 cards. The last option that Useberry implements is the randomized categories. By enabling this option, the categories will be presented in a randomized way to your participants. The same updates apply to open card sorting, with the difference that there are no categories since participants create them themselves, which is the main difference between open and closed cart sorting. Our updated cart sorting results make it easier to draw meaningful conclusions and present findings to stakeholders. For closed cart sorting, we have improved the cards view and we have implemented new categories and matrix analysis views. With the cards view, you can explore how cards were categorized by your participants and understand how they interpreted each card. You can see at a glance which cards were most commonly sorted into the same categories and which were split across different categories. It can also help you identify where your participants agree, where they have different ideas, and potentially if there were cart labels that they did not understand. With this update, you can now sort every column of this table in an ascending or descending order. Moving on to the new categories view, you can see a list of categories along with the number of cards that were placed within each category. You can also explore which cards participants sorted into each category. You can now sort each column of this table in an ascending or descending order. With the new matrix analysis, you can see the number of times each card was sorted into your preset categories and explore the most popular placement for each card. The number inside each cell where a card and a category intersect represents the number of participants who sorted that card into that category. Open the Show Percentage switcher to view percentages instead of counts. A darker shade of blue within the cells indicate a higher number of participants. Let's see our updated results for open card sorting, which make it easier to draw meaningful conclusions and present findings to stakeholders. We have improved the cards view and implemented new categories, standardization grid, and similarity matrix views. With the cards view, you can explore how cards were categorized by your participants and understand how they interpreted each card. You can see at a glance which cards were most commonly sorted into the same categories and which were split across different categories. It can also help you identify where participants agree, where they have different ideas, and potentially if there were card labels that they did not understand. With this update, you can now sort columns in ascending or descending order. If you standardize categories, as we'll see in the next step, the cards view will update its data, taking into consideration the standardization you have made. Moving on to the categories view, you can explore which cards participants sorted in each category, categories that participants created, and how participants named each of these categories. Compare the titles of each category to see the wording your participants used and check if they contain common cards. To make your results easier to analyze, standardize any categories where participants have grouped similar cards and created similar namings. You can standardize two or more categories into one by selecting these categories and clicking on the Standardize button. Once you do this, a pop-up will appear and you can see the agreement rate of the standardization. A higher percentage is more optimal. Let's give the standardized categories a name. You can unstandardize any of the standardized categories by selecting the standardized category and clicking Unstandardize. For the purpose of this demonstration, I will create one more standardization. Let's move to the standardization grid. The standardization grid shows a summary of your standardized data by presenting the distribution of cards across the different standardized categories. Each table cell shows the number of times a card was sorted into the corresponding standardized category. The darker the cell, the more participants agree with this grouping. Lastly, the similarity matrix. A similarity matrix helps you identify strong card pairings and groupings. This view displays the percentage of your participants who grouped any two cards in the same category. Each pair of cards indicates the proportion of users who grouped these two cards together. For example, change my password and communication settings were sorted together by all participants. The darker the cell, the more participants placed these cards together. Darker cells can help guide you in identifying potential groupings.